What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? My name is Nick, and today I have a very special video for you guys. We're going to be unboxing and taking a look at the brand new Xbox One S. It is sleeker, it is smaller, it is completely redesigned, and in today's video, I'm going to be unboxing it for you guys, reviewing it, comparing it to the previous model, and as well finish off talking about who exactly should buy one of these, and a little bit of who shouldn't buy one of these. So hopefully you guys enjoy the video. Alright, so before we actually begin the unboxing of the Xbox One S, there are some legal and transparency stuff that we need to go through just to keep everything kosher. So I did not buy this Xbox One S that you're about to see. It was provided to me by the nice people at Microsoft. They sent it to me and all they asked in return was an unboxing video for you guys, as well as some sort of semi-professional review. I don't even know what that means, but I think it's just a first impression. So yeah. I get to keep the console, but I am not getting paid any sort of secondary source of income or any other perks, benefits, F&B action, anything like that. It's just literally unboxing, review, keep the console, and everyone's happy. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Transparency is awesome, and enjoy the rest of the video. All right, so without further ado, let's get right into the unboxing here. So we'll start off with the packaging. So this is the 2 terabyte model. This is the largest Xbox One that Microsoft offers at the moment. And the only difference between this one, let's just say a 500 gigabyte Xbox One S, is that the 2 terabyte packaging does come with a free stand. So you can safely stand your Xbox One S vertically. And you can still buy the stand separately, but it's just a little bit of incentive to buy the biggest one that they possibly offer, I guess. And on the back, we have a little bit of a portrait of some of Microsoft's iconic franchises. We got some Forza here, some Gears of War, some Halo, and obviously last year, Tomb Raider had some timed exclusivities. So yeah, let's get right into it and see what's on the inside. I'm very excited. At the very top, we have setup guide in green, and this slides out right here. We got another package, a 14-day code for Xbox Live. I'm not going to scratch this out, so whoever gets it when this video goes live. I've already renewed my Xbox Gold membership for this year, so I have no use for it. And then we have the stand that you get to stand up the Xbox. Next on the inside, we have another box right here. And this box has a free HDMI cable. I remember when that was a big deal when you got these things, and now it's just like throwaways now. We have a power cable, which as you can see right now, this is the only power cable that you are going to need for this console. Yes, they finally got rid of the brick of doom that takes up so much space. So now it's literally the exact same cord that the PlayStation uses, which is super nice, especially if you're one of those people who like to travel a lot. And then we have the brand new Xbox One S controller. This is actually redesigned, and it comes now with Bluetooth capability, and there are some other upgrades that I'll talk about a little bit later. All right, last but not least, we have the actual console, and it is wrapped with a nice soft styrofoam, which is really, really nice. And then once again, wrapped again, and let's peel this baby off for the very first time. Oh, baby. That is one sexy console. I don't even want to touch it because I'm going to grummy it up with all my hands, but that is very sleek right there. So, as you can see, you have some grilling right here. I'm assuming that the fan, the exhaust is out there, so I would not put anything over top of that. You have some exhaust fans in the back as well. In terms of rear I/O, you have your Ethernet cable, an optical cable, IR out. You have two USB slots, one HDMI in, one HDMI out, and the power cable slot right there. So you probably notice there's something missing between this and the original Xbox One, and that is a slot for the Kinect. So it's kind of almost the nail in the coffin for the Kinect with this model. In order to actually use the Kinect, you have to buy a separate USB kind of dongle to attach it to one of these USB ports. So yeah, Xbox Kinect rip. All right, now that the console is out of the box, let's do some real life size comparables to some of the other consoles that you may be familiar with. So I think it's fitting that we'll start off with first the original Xbox One. So there you go, instant Xbox One OG. So as you can see, they're pretty much nipped and tucked in every single direction in terms of dimensions. It's not nearly as high, it's not nearly as deep, and it's not nearly as wide. It's supposed to be about 40% slimmer than the original Xbox One. And if for some reason you don't like this comparison, how about this one? This is how you can tell that this video is not sponsored in any sort of way. So for those of you who are unfamiliar with the size of an Xbox One in real life, we now have a PlayStation 4 as a reference point. So direct comparables, the PlayStation 4 when standing vertically is just a tiny bit shorter than the Xbox One S. It is just a tiny bit less wider than the Xbox One S as well. It reaches about to the point of the halfway point of this black bar right here. The PlayStation 4 is substantially larger though in the front. It is about 3.5 to 4 inches towards the camera, a little bit deeper. So you do save some space right there if you have a bit of a smaller shelf. So yeah, that is the direct size comparables. I'll be doing charts and stuff as well, close up pictures for you guys. Let's get right into the setup. All right, so we're now at my desk, my mini little NASA right here. And this is where I make all the videos that you guys watch for the channel. And we have the Xbox One S hooked up to the computer, and we're gonna take it on its maiden voyage for the channel. We're gonna go through that very first boot up, get everything set up. And what's nice is that the Xbox Live Summer Update just went live and you can now download it. And you will actually need that summer update to enable the 4K output, which is exclusive to the Xbox One S. Unfortunately, the monitors that you see behind me, they are not 4K compatible. They are only 2K compatible up to 1440p. So we will not be taking advantage of that feature. I do not have a 4K monitor inside the house anywhere to test out. So we'll just have to stick to the good old 1080p standby. But yeah, let's boot this up and see what we can see. All right, so I'm assuming that this boots up by pressing this button right here, and I am correct. And hopefully we get some output right here. There we go. It's going through its very first boot up. I should actually sync this controller as well. So the sync button on the new controller is on the same place as the old one, and the sync button on the console is on the bottom right here as well, just below the logo. I'm a red type of guy myself. Maybe not, yeah. Ooh, we got a little video. Raise up your arms, come one, come all. Oh! controller needs an update. What? Yes. Update my controller. Alright, so I think with the controller update, that pretty much wraps it up. So, a fresh console. There were two updates to the console and one update to the controller. Time-wise, that took about 25 minutes to do, which is actually a lot faster than it was on launch day of the Xbox One. Xbox One launch, I think the update took me about an hour and a half to get her done. So we cut it by a third of the time, which is an improvement, I guess. All right, just back on the topic of the Xbox One S controller, there are some minor upgrades that I wanted to talk to you guys about. And this extends as well to any controller that you'll find on the Xbox Design Lab. So if you make your own custom controller using the Design Lab, it'll have all the upgraded features that you'll find on the S controller. So first off, apparently, I can't tell personally myself, they upgraded the joysticks to make them feel a bit more fluid and more intuitive. Like I said, I can't really tell between that and a launch day Xbox One controller. This is a day one edition. Albeit these joysticks are a little bit more worn in, they're broken in, so it's hard to tell the difference, but apparently there is. And as well, just like the PlayStation 4 controller, they did add audio jack, 3.5mm audio jack to the bottom of the controller. So if you want some quick audio with like a pair of earbuds or something, you can plug them in quickly there. Probably the biggest feature that they added is Bluetooth capability. So if your computer or laptop supports Bluetooth, you will no longer need that little dongle to connect to it to use the controller wirelessly, which is a really nice feature. The dongle by itself is like 40 bucks. So to get Bluetooth for free and be able to play wirelessly is pretty big in my opinion. And as well, you can use it to play games on iOS on your phones or on Mac on your phones. So that's nice. And apparently you can also hook it up to an Nvidia Shield. So yeah, pretty neat. Bluetooth in itself is, I would say, if I were buying a new controller, it'd be the biggest thing for me because I don't have to pay for a dongle to connect my controller wirelessly to my computer, which is a nice feature. Alright, so that's it for the unboxing and the setup portion of the video. Let's move on to the nitty gritty and the review and who shouldn't buy this console and who should buy this console. So I guess we'll start off with who shouldn't buy this console. So the two main people, in my opinion, who should not buy an Xbox One S, should not. And this is just my personal opinion. The rest of the video is just my opinion. You can take it with a grain of salt, but this is just how I personally feel. So the first person that should not buy an Xbox One S is someone that already owns an Xbox One. If you already own an Xbox One, you should be perfectly fine with that model. There's really no reason to upgrade. The specs are exactly the same. The only difference is that the Xbox One S does have 4K upscaling. Personally, myself, I don't have a 4K monitor. I don't plan to buy one anytime soon. And it's just upscaling. I'm a native person myself. I prefer things to run in their native resolution. I'm not really a huge fan of upscaling. So if you already own an Xbox One, then you should probably not buy an Xbox One S. The second person, in my opinion, who should not buy an Xbox One S is someone who intends to purchase Project Scorpio. So just in case you missed it, just as a quick summary, Project Scorpio was officially announced at E3 this year. And what it is basically just an upgraded console. So it's still gonna be called the Xbox One, but it's gonna have more power underneath the hood, and it's just gonna be able to run games better. So especially if you already own an Xbox, the original Xbox, and you may be thinking of buying Project Scorpio, it really doesn't make much sense to me to buy an Xbox One S. Albeit Project Scorpio will probably be a lot more expensive than the original Xbox One and Xbox One S. If you plan to buy that, then I think you should just wait a year, skip the S version, and just hold off, save your money, and buy the upgraded version when it releases next year. All right, so for people who I think should buy an Xbox One S, I'm gonna start at the top most relevant, in my opinion, to the least relevant. And once again, this is all subjective. So the first person that should buy an Xbox One S is someone that doesn't already own an Xbox One. If you don't already own an Xbox One, and then it's a perfect time if you want one in the immediate future to do so. It's a smaller console, it has more features, it has a sexy white finish, and you really just can't go wrong. So if you don't already own an Xbox One, then you should definitely pick up an Xbox One S. So the next type of person who should buy an Xbox One S is just someone who wants a smaller console. So if you have limited entertainment unit space or limited desk space, the smaller form factor could be a really big deal to you. And this is especially true if you're someone like myself who travels a lot. I go to a ton of gaming conventions, PAXs, E3s, private events to check out some games early. And sometimes due to the hectic video game schedule, I need to bring my consoles with me and record in the hotel room so I can pump up videos while I'm away. And not only do I get to travel with a smaller console now, I no longer have to pack the power brick of doom. This thing is just so big. It's so ugly. So when the original Xbox One was announced, I was praying that they would have gotten rid of the power brick that was a part of the Xbox 360. And when I unboxed it and found the power brick, it's literally a piece of me died. Just look at the size of this thing. It's literally a quarter of the size of the console. Let me put that up right there for you guys. Literally, well, maybe not a quarter, but fairly substantial. So the fact that they got rid of the power brick and there's literally just one wire now, the exact same wire that they used for the PlayStation 4, I am a happy camper, and it makes me more willing to be able to carry this around in my luggage. Transporting your video game console and luggage is sketchy enough by itself, and the fact that I only have to carry the bare console makes me a very happy person. So if you're a person who needs a smaller form factor or a person who travels a lot, and then the Xbox One S may be something that you'd be interested in. And the final, probably less relevant and kind of silly reason to buy an Xbox One S is simply because you want a white console. And that's it. And I'm not one to judge. I've done it before. I'll be honest with you. I bought the original Xbox 360 at launch. Actually went through a couple of them because of the whole Red Ring issue. And when they announced the Xbox 360 Elite, instant pre-order, they had my money. And the only reason I bought it was because it was black. If you guys remember, there were no differences between the two. Hardware-wise, it was exactly the same on the inside. Design-wise, on the outside, it was exactly the same. It had a tiny bit of a bigger hard drive that came with the console, but other than that, it was the exact same console, and I rebought it again just because it was black. At that time, in my entertainment unit, when I was in school, everything was black, and I kind of thought that the white Xbox 360 stuck out a little bit like a sore thumb. I didn't really like it, and OCD-ness on my part. I just wanted a black console, and yeah, that's the only reason I bought it. So it's a reason. It's not a huge reason. I wouldn't say it's a valid reason, but it is a reason. And all my OCD brothers out there will know. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's it for my unboxing setup and overview of the Xbox One S. Once again, I would like to thank Microsoft for providing the console for me to unbox on the channel and show you guys. As well, I get to keep it, which is really, really nice and awesome and very kind of them. And as well, I've provided you guys some tips and suggestions of whether or not you should be in the market for one of them. If you are in the market for an Xbox One S, I do have an Amazon affiliate link in the description. If you use it, I do get a small percentage of the sale just for transparency wise, you know, just help me out a little. But other than that, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you enjoyed the video, drop the video a quick thumbs up or a thumbs down if you didn't like it. Let me know what you guys think, and yeah, that's pretty much it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed, and I shall see you guys next time, all right? As always, have a wonderful day.